To be honest, guys, I was so freaking stressed, but I got there in the end and I got that sweet, sweet icon. Funnily enough, I would rather this be like 500 Lumamba than a collectible, but that's just me, okay? Hi, welcome back to another Alchemy Stars video. My name is Lace, and today we're gonna be talking about Endgame, kind of like a collection of guides. If there's no guides, then how should you look for some things that are more appropriate for you? In this video, I'm gonna try to give you kind of like all of the different tools that you could potentially use to go out and find your own guides, because like, as we all know, this event is, it's very variable. And what I mean by that is like, not everybody's gonna have every unit. Like for me, like there was so many MBT or like max breakthrough Sicarios that were required, and I didn't have a max breakthrough Sicario, and I also don't have hero, and I also don't, yeah, there's just too many problems. And so yeah, I'm gonna go through a whole bunch of different compilations. I'm gonna go through a couple of different users or like publishers who have published some like really cool strats. I've also found a couple of low rarity clears or low rarity clear guides, because I know some of you have started like quite recently. And on top of that, I will show you guys some CN and JP clears, as well as the keywords that are necessary to go and look them up. Because again, unless you guys have like all of the units, this is going to be like a really, really tailored event. There are a few that are very repeatable, but like for the most part, they aren't. And without further ado, let's get into it. And so I want to point out here that we still have 10 days as this video drops. Now, why exactly is this 10 days significant? It's because there is still a lot of time for investment. And the reason I want to point that out is because if you guys think back to like when I did my other endgame video, like my little rant, a whole bunch of my Aurorians were actually not even juiced, right? So if we have a look at my lineup, you're going to realize that there are a lot more characters here now. In a matter of like 3 or 4 or 5 days or something, I've gotten my Filishai, my Araya, my Sicare, and my Luis all to A3 now, A3-1. My Araya was even at A10. And so like, all I'm trying to say is that with some level of investment, with some time, I reckon you guys can push further than what you already are at. And so without further ado, let's run through a couple of these different guides. And so our first stop is a 12.8k point low rarity low investment guide. Massive shout out to you, Berrylicious, for putting together this guide. Not only has he done a written guide, but he also has a bunch of the videos to go with it. And so all of those videos are actually compiled in this playlist over here, and I'm pretty sure that they are quite repeatable. However, what is so great about this is that he actually goes through a whole bunch of the different characters, shows how these 3 to 5 stars, predominantly 3 and 4 stars actually, how these characters with just a little bit of investment can actually carry you up to 12.8k points. However, if we're going for like a low investment clear, we are going to have some power somewhere, right? And so generally speaking, that power is going to be coming from your support units. And so as you can see, these support units are predominantly carries, right? They are dealing big, big damage. And if you guys do end up using this guide, I do want to point out that the hero needs breakthrough 3. And this is actually a massive thing. I'm pretty sure every single guide for any forest team has used a breakthrough 3 hero. And so at this point, it's very, very important for you guys to go over to like the Discord, either Chill Stars or like the official one, and go make some friends that do have the breakthrough 3 heroes at about level 60 to 80, especially for this one, because it is low investment. I reckon it's going to be relatively easy to find like a 6-star Regal at level 80. Probably easy-ish to find a Michael, but a breakthrough 3 hero, like you definitely need it, because this is going to make or break your strategy. But just scrolling through this one really quick, he goes through a lot of like the different rationale and the logic that he uses to beat them. I think generally speaking, as long as you have these like units juiced up, and it's probably not going to take you too long, you should be able to hit this 12k point. So again, Filishai is just so freaking big. So yeah, for you guys who are looking for low clears, hopefully this is going to help you out. And again, thank you to Berrylicious for putting this one together. All right, next we've got Alter Rondo, who actually has posted so many freaking clears. So if I click into this one over here, and then we have a look at this on the right hand side, you can see that he has actually done budget clears for every single one of these bosses. And again, 10 days, like this may be achievable, this may not be achievable. Like hopefully you'll be able to pick something up in terms of like between this one and Berrylicious's guides. In worst case scenario, you can just tune them down a little bit just to make it work for you. But on the topic of Alter Rondo is like, I think a lot of people would say that he's probably the closest thing to Kjostin V from a Western point of view. You can see that he's done a whole bunch of different videos, and so just a massive shout out to him. I think he's been doing it ever since like the game's freaking launched. You can see that he does a lot of the Spire stuff, but he also does a lot of clear guides, especially from like a budget point of view. But there are definitely some in there that are not budget, which would get you those like 18k points. For example, this one over here, Endgame Deceptive Queen 3.3k Regal. I actually use this one to get my 3.3k on the Deceptive Queen. And so again, massive shout out to Alter Rondo. He's got the budget guides, and he's got some of like the mid to high tier guides. And so that being said, let's head over to our next resource, which is this bad boy over here. So some of the guys over at the official Discord has actually put this one together, because like I said from my last video, there was a lot of encouragement in terms of like putting together like endgame guides. And the reason is because there's kind of like an event going on, and so people are just flooding the guides chat, right? And so what you see here is a result of that. And so they've actually put together a spreadsheet, kind of like an index, to like kind of collate all of these guides together. So along the bottom, we've got all 6 bosses, and then in each of these, we have the clear records. So we have each of these line items as a clear. But not only that, they've actually put together the requirements over here, which is super, super useful, because again, I reckon that these breakthroughs are probably the biggest gappers, or like the biggest blockers from you actually clearing this content or following their guide step by step. And so yeah, not overly much to talk about for this one. So this one was less helpful for me, just because like the sheer number of guides that I've been using, like MBT, Sicares, or that the breakthrough requirements were just so freaking high that I could not use any of them. Actually, you know what? This is exactly the one that I use for Felix, the one by Jung. And so Jung, hashtag 5338, if you are out there watching, thank you so much, my man. But yeah, hopefully you guys will be in a more fortunate position than me. Maybe you'll have like the Araya BT Max or like the Sicare BT Max. And so therefore, a lot of you guys can go ahead and actually try out some of these guides. However, it's not all like the high rarity clears. If you scroll down to like the bottom, there are some of like the lower rarity clear ones. And so as you can see over here, Berrylicious, and we've got AdGen over here. Actually, on the topic of AdGen, he's probably the next person that we are going to segue to. But before we go, again, to summarize, I think it's pretty straightforward. You can click on each of these tabs and then you can scroll through and select one. Hopefully you guys will have the requirements. Again, you just really need to be careful about these MBTs or these BTs or whatever, because again, it is going to make or break your comp. It pretty much broke all of my comps. All right, so back to AdGen. So AdGen is a creator for Alchemy Stars that has been doing, I think, videos for... I'm pretty sure he's been around since the game was launched. And so if we hop into this channel, we've got the videos over here. And so yeah, as you can see, he's been doing these Alchemy Stars videos for ages. However, for Endgame, he has been putting in the work. And so like, there is another source of information if you do want to try him out. Me personally, I'm pretty sure I've clicked into like 5 or 6 of these videos, but like they just didn't work out for me because I didn't have the units or I was looking for something else, right? And so yeah, if any of these look good to you, go over to AdGen's and like tell him I freaking sent you, you know? Hopefully they will help you out. And so guys, I have shown you this before. Essentially, this is the official Alchemy Stars Discord. And so if you have a look on the left-hand side, you'll see that there is an end games guides here and also an end games guides over here as well. And so if you have not joined the Discord before, you'll probably not be able to see the end games guide thread over here. And so all you have to do is click over here in the guides. And then up here, you see this hashtag, you can click threads and then you can click into the end game guides. After that, that should put you into these threads. And like, I think you just need to hit join threads or something to have this one persist for you. On the other hand, I think you can actually click into here and you can just click onto this guy over here. But yeah, a lot of the guides that we've gone through, a lot of the guides that are from the Discord, like they have been collated over here. So yeah, just scrolling through this Talos Mistake, there's a familiar face. We've got Berrylicious over here, AdGen over here. Going up a bit more, we've got Siap, which is also Rondo. And yeah, there are a lot of guide makers actually. And hopefully you will find something over here. This one is pretty cool. But yeah, from the Discord side, I do have a couple or a lot. So I've been collating like quite a few actually. And so this is probably where I think the most value is going to come from for you guys. And it's that no one else has really ventured into the CN or the JP territory. Or I didn't go to KR yet because I don't know how to type KR. But what I will do is I will leave a whole bunch of the keywords down in the description below. And what I mean by that is that I will leave the keywords like Alchemy Stars, Endgame, and like each of the bosses' names. And what this will let you do is that you're going to be able to actually look up the JP or the CN videos. Generally speaking, for JP videos, you're going to be looking on YouTube. However, you need those keywords. And so for example, if we have a look at this video over here, this is it's Alchemy Stars, but it's not really Alchemy Stars. Like when you translate it, it's like White Knight Aurora. And then the words after that is Endgame. And then this one over here is the boss name. And so for JP, you know what, let's just run through it real quick. And so guys, you can see the keywords over here. So this is the Alchemy Stars bit. This is the Endgame bit. And then for example, this one over here, these 5 characters, this represents Desolate Monarch and etc. And so like, again, I will drop these keywords into the description below. And so you can search YouTube for each of these JP clears. Actually, I think Vani is this one over here. Honestly, I can't read Japanese. I'm going to be honest. Okay. I can read some Chinese. I can read barely any Japanese, but like, I digress. Let's go on. On the other hand, what we can do is head over to Bilibili. So a lot of you pre-com players already know I get a lot of information from Bilibili. And essentially this is your Chinese YouTube. So I'm not sure if all these keywords are gonna work. I think a lot of this is gonna work. So let me put that back over there. But again, for these keywords, I will drop them down into the description below as well. And so you guys will have a little bit of luck actually navigating this site. And I'm not sure if this is gonna work, but yeah, let's have a look. Oh, there we go. Yeah, it did work. All right. And so as you can see, we've got a whole bunch of search results. It is exactly as it looks like. For me personally, I picked up a lot of the interesting ones and put them into my Discord. But again, I will drop the keywords so that you guys can find exactly what you're looking for. For me personally, I'm pretty sure I used like 2 CN clears, 1 Western clear, or like 1 global clear. And then I unga-bungered like the 2 of them and it kind of worked out. Honestly, I just want to show you guys like some of the big brain plays. So this is the one that I use for Vani. Man, this one is really freaking cracked. And so as you can see, this is quite low investment. Yes, it is featuring a lot of the 6 stars, but this is kind of like the state that I'm in. And so for example, if you do have like the Cinsa, the Charon, the Smoky, which I still don't have, the Icy, the Filishai, then you can probably use clears like this. But like, it's, man, there is some really big brain stuff going on over here. So look at this horse. And essentially what's happening is he is juggling the horse and the rook to only be able to hit him one at a time. And so let me just make that big and show you guys a little bit more. So essentially this rook is stuck here. He can't ever touch the Cinsa, and so he just keeps navigating between these 2 squares, and the rook and the horse will just go back and forth. So as you can see over here, Smoky is being used to teleport in position, and then he's gonna walk up and end up on this square over here. What's gonna happen is this horse is gonna go off, and then this rook is gonna come back over here, and then he's just gonna keep freaking alternating between these 2 squares. It's actually really crazy. Bam, bam, bam. And then this just goes into perpetuity. He just keeps doing this until it dies. See, he just went back and then the rook came back and then he's gonna go back up there. But yeah, I'm pretty sure all of you guys do know, don't sleep on the Eastern resources. They are really freaking big brain as well. Again, keywords, I will drop them in the description. If you guys do want to see a couple of the ones I've curated, come join the Discord. But otherwise, I think it's time for the secret message, and it would be TY Guide Bros. Because massive shout out to all of you big brain people, because like, well, I don't know, I couldn't have solved this on my own. Thank you to all you creators who actually put in the time and effort to not only find solutions, but then to also like record them and put them up on YouTube and stuff like that. Thank you to the Western Guide Bros. Thank you to the Eastern Guide Bros. Thank you, Guide Bros. And so if you could drop that secret message, thank you, Guide Bros, down into the description below, I would really appreciate it, because it means you've watched up until the end of the video. And so thank you guys so much. But otherwise, please consider a like, a sub, a comment. You already know what it is. And if you would like to support the channel, we have a few ways down in the description below. We've got a membership thing and some affiliate links. But otherwise, as a desolate monarch once said, all good things must come to an end. And so thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll catch you guys in the next video. Bye-bye.